Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Chapter 1, Network and Communication. Today we will start communication devices. From this word communication devices, we will come to know that these are the hardware. So communication devices are the devices which are used for the transformation of information between the computers and other devices. There are four types of communication devices: dial-up modem, network interface card, router, switch. But today we will discuss only two commonly used devices: dial-up modem and network interface card. Dial-up modem is the abbreviation of modulator and demodulator. MO for modulator, DEM for demodulator. It is a communication device. It is used to connect the internet using the telephone lines. It is used to exchange the information between the computers. It is used to send the data from one computer to the other. It is used to translate the information in a form that can be transmitted over the telephone lines. The speed of dial-up modem is 56 kilobits per second, which is very slow. So dial-up modem was replaced by DSL for faster internet. A modem can be located inside the computer, and outside the computer. It can be wired or it can be wireless. Data or information that is stored in computers is in the form of digits. Digits or binary numbers are zeros and one. Zero represent off, one represent on. Here bits are shown, one represent on. Zero represents off. Here a combination of 8 bits is shown, which make a 1 byte. To store a single character that may be capital, that may be small, that can be any numbers, to store a character, 8 bits are required to store a character into the computer memory. So this is a combination of 8 bit. Suppose that we want to save a single character A into the computer memory. So when we will save this A into computer, 8 bit will be saved into the computer memory. When we will open this file, file again, it will show us this data again into the form of which a human can understand it easily. Analog signals are shown in the diagram. Analog signals include all the values, or the all the positive values and all the negative values. All the positive values above the horizontal line and all the negative values below the horizontal lines. Similarly, digital signals are the discrete numbers, discrete values that are zeros and one, only zeros or and one. The presence of the pulse represent the one. The absence of the pulse represent the zero. Similarly, the presence of the pulse represent 1, the absence of the pulse represent 0. It means digital signals are the combinations of zeros and 1. Data or information that can be transmitted over the telephone lines in the form of analog signals. Let us understand the concept how information or data travels on the telephone lines. As already I have told you that information that is stored in computers is in the form of digits or binary numbers. Modem converts this digital data into the analog signals, so that can be transmitted over the telephone lines, because telephone lines can carry only the analog signals. In this diagram, you can see that there is a modem on the sender side. This modem will convert the digital signals into the analog signals, which will be transmitted over the telephone lines. Again, on the receiving end, there is a modem which will convert these analog signals again into the digital signals. So computer can represent the information into its memory. As I have told you that computer can transmit both analog signals into the digital signals and the digital signals into the analog signals. When modem converts the digital signals into analog signals, this process is called the modulation. When modem converts the analog signals into the digital signals, then this This process is called the demodulation. Interesting information, the first dial-up modem was built in 1962 and it had a speed of 300 bits per second. The second one, communication device, is expansion card, which is used to connect the computers to create a computer network. It makes the communication possible. Without network interface card, computers cannot communicate with each other. In this diagram, you can see this is a network. Here, computers can communicate with each other, which is possible only if NIC is inserted inside the system unit. NIC, as I have told you, NIC is necessary for the networking of the computers to make the communication possible between the computers. Network interface card, NIC, as shown in this diagram, this one is the network interface card and these are the expansion slots. This is inserted on the motherboard. This one NIC card is inserted on these expansion slots so that communication can be made possible. There is a unique serial number that is printed on all the NIC network interface cards that is used to identify the computer on the network. This network interface card can be wired, can be wireless. This here you can see that this one network interface card, when we insert it on the modem on expansion slots, there is a port where we connect the cable. So this is a wireless NIC card. Question answers, how modem works, show diagrammatically. Write the answer of the question in your copies. Second question, long question, part 5. What are the communication devices? Any two of them. I have mentioned the answer. I have pasted the answers from your book. If you want to write the answers from the slides, you can write. If you want to write the answer from your book, you can write. Both are correct. Thank you. Allah Hafiz and best of luck.